Hello and welcome to MR-CFD. In this video, I'm going to show you how to generate the geometry of this product, which is a validation of a controller flow past a dimpled circular cylinder paper. To start generating the geometry, first you should open a workbench window. After opening a workbench window, you should actually click on fluid, and drag it into the blank window. You see there are some sections, geometry, mesh setup, etc. To start creating the geometry in SpaceClaim software, right click on it, then click on new SpaceClaim geometry, then the SpaceClaim will be opened for you. So a SpaceClaim window is opened like this, and we can start to create the geometry. Go to a sketch section, and from this part you can choose circle command, and from the center draw a circle width of 40 millimeters diameter. And now go to 3D mode, the surface is created, click on the surface, and as you see, the pull command is activated automatically. If not, you can choose it and click on it and pull it up and get about 400 millimeters. Yes, and now it's time to create the dimples. To do that, select the surface around the cylinder and go to design section, choose a plane. Yes, the plane is created on the surface of the cylinder. And now go to a sketch mode. Yes, and try to look at it in this view. Very good. And now again choose line command, and from here you can draw a line by 4 millimeters length. Yes, double click. This way you can exit from line command. And now again back to design section, from body section choose a sphere and activate no merge. This way if we create a sphere, the solid created is separate from the cylinder. So from this point, create a cylinder with 4 millimeters diameter, enter. Now the sphere is created, and now by escape key on your keyboard, you can exit from this command. Now go to sketch, and choose trim command to remove this line. Okay. So now we have two solids, the cylinder and the sphere. If you go to 3D mode, you can see the sphere is created inside the cylinder. Now we have to deactivate the plane. Go to design section and choose linear pattern. Choose your desired solid, which is this one. It asks you to choose the direction. This is the direction, this side actually, and we want to have 50 dimples, in which the distance between them is 8 millimeters. Again, choose it. That's it. Yes, very good. And now click on this part, so all the dimples in this direction are created. Now it's time to repeat these dimples around the circle. To do that, go to circular pattern, and now choose the pattern. The direction would be this circle, we want to have 8 actually dimples around the cylinder in 360 degrees. So click on it, yes. As you see, they are created. Okay. Now it's time to intersect the spheres from the cylinder body. To do that, we should choose combine command and choose the cylinder, then choose the spheres, actually the pattern as the cutter. It takes a longer time because it's going to be actually separated from the cylinder. And yes, as you see, a lot of solids are created. And now we want to delete the solids created. It's better to back to select command and delete all the created solids one by one. Or we can choose the last one, get shift key on the keyboard, and then right click on them and delete. So yeah, now we have only one solid, and this time we should click on the pattern, right click on it, and then delete. This way all the spheres are removed from the cylinder. And we have only one solid. If you zoom out, you can see all of them are removed. Our next step is creating the other dimples. To do that, click on the plane, then by a move command, move it in Z direction, and then we should rotate this plane about 22.5 degrees. Yes, like this. And now we should move the plane so that it would be attached to the cylinder. Choose up to command, yes. Then click on the cylinder. And now move it about 20 millimeters. Yes, now it is attached to the surface around the cylinder. Now create a sketch on the plane and try to see it in this view. Now it's time to create a dimples on the cylinder. To do that, choose the line command and from the center draw a line by 8 millimeters length. I should draw it again. Yes, 8 millimeters. And now go to design and choose a sphere, activate no merge, and from this point create a sphere in which the diameter is 4 millimeters. You see the solid of sphere is created, and now by trim command remove this edge. If you go back to a 3D mode, you can see the sphere is created inside the cylinder. And now it's time to make the pattern. Go to design section, choose linear pattern, choose the sphere, and then choose the direction. And here I want to have 48 spheres in which the distance between them is 8 millimeters. Yes, I think another one is needed, so I put 49. As the number of repeated spheres in the pattern, and now click on the green check mark. Now the pattern is made like this. And now it's time to make the pattern around the cylinder. To do that, go to the pattern, choose the direction of around the cylinder. Yes, here is the pattern around the cylinder. And next step is separating the spheres from the cylinder. So choose combine command, choose the cylinder, and now choose the pattern, actually the spheres as cutter. This way, a lot of solids, including separated spheres, are made. And now we should remove them so that they are removed from the cylinder. So select the first one, then go to this one, get shift key on keyboard and delete, continue. By the other ones, delete. Keep on deleting. Yes. Okay. Now we have the solid like this. And now if you click on the pattern and click on delete, you see the spheres are removed from the cylinder, and now we have only one solid. Next step, I want to create the domain around the cylinder. To do that, from the middle of the cylinder, I make a plane. Then I rotate the geometry. Then create a sketch. Oh, sorry, before that, move the plane about 150 millimeters. And next step, we should create a sketch on this plane. So click on it, go to sketch mode, yes. And look at the geometry or the sketch in this view, and now by using rectangle command from the center of the sketch, draw a rectangle in which the length of this side is 250 millimeters, and now this side dimension should be changed by dimension command, in which the length is 3000 millimeters, or actually 3 meters. Now, by using a mirror command, repeat the rectangle so that we can have the real one. Yes, change the mirror plane and repeat these edges. Yes, now we have the bigger one, and now we can remove extra edges by this command, which is trim. Now back to a 3D mode. This way we have the surface, and now by activating no merge, we can pull the surface about 300 millimeters. So this way the domain around the cylinder is made. As you see, we have two solids. If you click on them, you can check, and if you deactivate one of them, you can see the other one. Yes, the cylinder inside the domain is shown like this. Next step is actually make the cylinder inside the domain be as a whole. But before that, we have to separate the cylinder from the domain. To do that, we use combine command. We chose the whole domain as the target, and we use the cylinder inside as the cutter. This way you see two solids are created, and now if you check, you can decide which one should be deleted. This one should be deleted, and of course this one. So yeah, now we have only one solid in which the cylinder inside has been removed. And now to show that the cylinder inside is a kind of hole in this domain, we can select this surface, and by using pull command, push it 50 millimeters. Yes, that's it. If you zoom in, you can see the cylinder as a whole inside the domain. And now it's time to repeat actually this action for the other side, and push it about 60 millimeters. This way, yeah, you can see the cylinder as a whole on both sides of the domain. So the geometry now is ready. You can see it in this view. After closing a SpaceClaim window, it's time to click on Mesh to open Ansys Meshing software. Ansys Meshing window is opened like this, and you can see the geometry has been loaded here. And now it's time to first of all name different boundaries of the geometry, and then start to mesh it. To name the boundaries of the geometry, first choose the face from this toolbar, and choose this one, right click on it, create name selection, and name it as off. Then click on the other faces around it by getting control key on your keyboard. Then right click on it and create name selection, and name it as side down wall. Side down. Next step I right click on the geometry and choose select all, so all the faces and surfaces are selected. But now by getting control key on the keyboard, actually unselect the faces around. Also this one. And this one. So only the wall actually around the cylinder is selected, and right click on it, create name selection, and name it as wall. Yes. And now click on it, this surface, right click, create name selection, name it as outlet. And the last one to be named is the inlet, right click, name selection, and name it as inlet. And now select body from this toolbar and choose the body, right click on it, and name it as the fluid. So okay. Now you can see different boundaries that we have named, upside down wall, outlet, etc. Okay, and now click on mesh. And make sure that physics preference is on CFD, and we want to give sizing to this geometry to be meshed in element size. Change it to 2 centimeters. Also, try to expand sizing section, and in the feature size, yes, the feature size is actually 0.1 millimeters. So we can actually make sure that wherever of the geometry is small, the meshing would be done properly. And after that, it's time to define a method for meshing. For this geometry, we should have a structured mesh. So right click on mesh, insert method, choose the body, here apply, so the body is selected, and here method should be on hex dominant. Okay, and now right click on mesh and then generate mesh, so the process of meshing has started. Hope this video is helpful for you. To benefit from Mr. CFD services, including simulation, consultation, and training, visit our website www.mrcfd.com or contact us via info@mrcfd.com.